this is reasonable advice too, I think.
Where the problem area lies, people think it lies in taking too much. It lies in taking too little, because if you take too little, you can resist it. You can struggle with it, and then it can turn into a real mess. And you actually have the power to some degree to resist it. What you want to do is take efficiently enough that there's no escape, and that the transition from ordinary reality to fully loaded is as quick as possible, because it's somewhat terrifying. For example, let's use the example as the monitor. Eating raw mushrooms.
We'll be right back. faster and smarter. Maybe they'll come a point where you need to be faster. Get faster and smarter.
Thank you. Thank you. insofar as we have an original mind of some kind, that original mind is not in fact pure. The original mind, insofar as again we have it, is a mind that's beset by problematic tendencies, and it always has been. Indeed, in traditional understanding, it's been that way for numerous lifetimes. The notion of an original mind is also problematic for other reasons, in that it at least appears to reify the notion of a mind as something that's permanent, that's always been there, and always will be there, which is an idea that's rejected in early Buddhism. Now, there are ways of understanding the original mind on which this is not true, where that original mind is a mind of emptiness, is a mind of non-self, in some sort of paradoxical sense. I think that we should consider.
the direction that I want to go in, what I want to achieve for me, what I want to give back to humanity. At some point, for you, you have to decide.